of step in the things that we would all be talking to them about.
But it didn't in 2013.
In Bedford, there are not only local and parish elections, but a mayoral contest too. It's the only town in the East with an elected mayor. And the Lib Dems are hoping to hold on to the role they've had since 2009. One of the key battlegrounds is the planned merger of the local hospital with Luton and Dunstable, which has been delayed since it was first announced more than 18 months ago. Here's Andy Holmes.
The River Great Ouse may flow smoothly through Bedford, but the waters around this hospital merger are slightly choppier. Originally planned for April 2018, this joining together with the Luton and Dunstable is now a year overdue. The town's incumbent mayor, Dave Hodgson, has long campaigned to retain key services on the site.
It's about making sure we keep A&E. We've seen how important A&E is for us. It's about maternity and paediatrics. 2,000 births in Bedford Hospital. No hospital around the area can actually cope with those births if we didn't have maternity. So it's essential we have those. We need to be able to be born in Bedford.
A lack of funds seems to be the reason for this delay, but the Conservative candidate says if and when it does happen, it will actually save money.
The reason the merger needs to happen is because it's a merger of two trusts. So you go to from two trusts to one trust, you've got half the running costs. They reckon they're going to save between 10 and 14 million pounds a year. That's a huge amount of money to save that can be invested in frontline services and doctors, nurses, where we need it to be invested.
Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn visited Bedford in his 2017 general election campaign to highlight issues with the hospital. His party's candidate in this election isn't sure that the merger is needed.
If it is the only way of making sure that we retain all our core services at Bedford Hospital, then obviously we would want it to happen and as soon as possible. If, however, that is not the case, then perhaps the money would be far better spent extending facilities here.
This merger has been postponed twice already, meaning a lack of clarity for staff and patients. The Green candidate says this isn't helping anyone.
Always with delay, you get uncertainty, and with uncertainty, productivity goes. People start losing focus, they start looking for more certainty, move to other jobs. So you'll probably be losing talent, putting off investment decisions. It's just really, really unhelpful. Need to have transparency and real clarity about what's going on.
UKIP also have a candidate in this mayoral election who wasn't available to film with us today. Their take on the merger is that they don't support it and they don't see any benefit to patients in continuing to spend money on merger discussions when it's not actually improving clinical care.
We still don't know yet when the funding for this merger will be approved, but with the mayoral election results due this Friday, our wait to gauge the delay's impacts on the polls will be nowhere near as long.